summer evening. You can probably hear the distant sounds of traffic. You may be able to hear some central air units, the slight hum. You may hear some little buzzing and tapping as some beetles and moths are attracted to the single solitary bulb that is lighting everything here. There's hardly any breeze, which is unfortunate because I was hoping for that, but maybe that's a good thing, because if there was a breeze, I may not be able to whisper. So, I have a special little evening planned for you. Whether you're having trouble sleeping, suicidal thoughts, any number of things that can make for the least ideal mood and experience. And part of my being here, I guess, my existence now, is to be a tool for your escape. I'm like an instrument. Not to sound pompous or egotistical, but when you think about it, it's kind of, well, anyway. So, I have this hat, which is probably going to make quite a lot of appearances. Of matches, because I plan to light right here. I purchased this as a prop. So I'm going to be lighting this first, so we'll get to that after this, after I show you everything here. I have this shaker. Thin that twine is, like 1/16. 1/32, something like that. Goes right through the center of the seed. I don't know what kind of seeds they are. But this is some kind of gourd. Sound of this shaker is the beads as they rattle against the gourd and shake. So I'm not going to be shaking it, but I purchased this as a prop for Sowande video, which is will be coming up not soon after this video, after I get to Bloodborne and a very other special video right after this one. I also found this wooden pestle and mortar. You might hear some beeping in the background, and I think there might be some construction going on not too far from here. But, yeah, this is my third pestle and mortar, and I purchased this for some more Victorian era, medieval era videos. Especially the Bloodborne video, which I have been working on for weeks, just trying to absorb all the lore and figure out how I want to play it out, at least the very first video. Stick. hand is another prop for the upcoming Sowande video. Then I have this other hurricane lamp that I picked up at a thrift store. Just pulling the price tag off now. It's another oil lamp. Just a few little objects to that I thought would be nice to try and just do something a little different. So why don't we light this oil lamp? Like I said, I have the box of matches. Thank you. so I hope life is treating you well. And if that's the case, I hope it continues. Although, let's be frank, life is not perfect. That's not anything most people want to hear. But, you know, we can try our best to make quick work of the down times, so we can get to the good times, the upswing, and try to make those last. Just lighting this for the ambiance. said, this is a very clean oil. That's, burning, inside here. But you still want to light these in a ventilated area. So, I'm going to put this, and like I said, I want to use this for some, ASMR videos. Especially when I go out in the shed or something. Like the bounty hunter or the, that one video where the guy that collects all the stuff in the shed, I forget, the scavenger. Doesn't even matter. The fact of the matter is that that's where he was now, today, in that wheelchair, and there's lots of folks like that. So there he is at the bus stop on a busy street, and cars, trucks, minivans just driving by, and I'm thinking to myself, that's the human race, in a nutshell. But I know we all have our own lives to live. We're busy. We're going to work. And I feel that society decompress, relax. not to mention all the things, all the responsibilities we have outside of the job. So it makes it difficult for someone to want to have time to help someone else. Even though it doesn't take much, but, you know, I'm not saying that all the people that drove by this guy are guilty or feel ashamed. I don't play that game. But if we had more time back in our lives, if we didn't have to work so much, go to school so much financial pressure, then we might have more time to be more of a community, more of a human race than we are today. That's really what I mean. I try to put myself into as much of an objective mindset that I can, when I can, as often that I can, and see the forest for the trees. Try to look at life as if you're an alien from another planet. You came down here and you're just witnessing all this for the first time. And I see this guy in a wheelchair waiting to get a ride somewhere. Meanwhile, all these people that have the ability, the transportation, cars, minivans, and trucks, could take that guy where he needs to go. But they're too busy. And that's like another tragedy in itself. Not a tragedy, I mean, but... I wish things, I'm an idealist, and being an idealist sometimes means I'm not thinking rationally, because the world will never be perfect or ideal or a utopia as much as I wish it could be. But I think with some changes in society that we can try to work towards having more time and having more compassion. That's a huge factor in my life, and I'm probably sure in yours as well. I know the one thing that seems to bring a lot of us together here in the ASMR community is empathy, compassion, being highly sensitive, folks. And it's a beautiful thing. I know I'm not the only one who thinks this way. But I just wanted to say that it's been stuck in my craw. And it really impacted me. I mean, I've always been that type of empath. Where I see a situation, a person, and I just feel so deeply. And it really impacts me. It's like, man, I wish just that guy didn't have to be in that wheelchair waiting for the bus. I wish life was just so much better for so many people that struggle. And it's just... You know, I'm not the only one who thinks this way. And there's plenty of people out there who just don't care. You know, the human race is one giant melting pot of so many different types of people. I hope one day we can reach something close to utopia. You know? We're not fighting and killing each other and like this sound. It's not something that I've used that often or ever. Like I said, I don't really know if I've ever used a rain stick before, but this is going to be a Sowande's. And of course, you know, I read the comments, so if this is something that you'd like me to use, you know, in traditional videos, please let me know. It doesn't always have to be in a character, theatrical video. I'm not sure if you're an empath, you know, someone that has empathy. I'm kind of the mindset that I sometimes think that empathy is a trait and not everyone has it, which might explain a lot of things. I've looked up trait empathy, and I'm not really sure if that's the same thing I'm thinking. But if you're an empath or you have someone that has empathy, it's like a blessing and a curse, because sometimes think about the correlation between or among ASMR, empathy, and being a highly sensitive person. And again, a highly sensitive person just means that your nervous system is more sensitive to stimuli. It doesn't mean you're special or anything like that. Just how the body works. So, I sometimes wonder if people who feel deeply or have empathy and who are highly sensitive, you know, what's the combination? So you would fill this with oil. There's two parts here. It's the oil chamber, the reservoir, I guess, and there's the top, the chimney. Protects the flame. This actually all comes apart. I love these things. There's just... I'm starting to collect, mostly for props, but I'm starting to collect a lot of older things, antique things, but not any crazy antiques. I'm not that kind of collector. I'm not really a collector, but I like trying to create just a visual appeal or mood to certain videos. Not to mention these things are just something about them. There's a little dial right here which feeds the wick up through a slot, really, as it burns, so you can keep that's that part. And then here is the, oil. The base of the hurricane lamp, oil lamp, where you put the oil in. This one had some really old oil. It was pretty nasty. It was tough to clean out. I need to get some more oil to fill this up, but I need a new wick. Since the old wick was saturated with this really old oil, I didn't want to burn it. So, and of course, this is the chimney. Not sure if you've ever had one of these or known someone that has, or parents, grandparents, whatever, sons, grandsons, anyone you know. This was only $15, so not too expensive. And some folks light them just for the ambiance. Were primarily used for when electricity would go out, and folks would light these. But oil is much more expensive, and not the greatest thing to use anymore these days. But occasionally it's all right, I think. So, we're winding down here. And either at this time you're asleep, and I'm just talking to your room, or your unconscious self. You're still with me. Whatever the case may be, I hope that state of mind than when you started this video. So, as always, I like to thank you for joining. I want to wish you all my best on your own little journey in life, on your own path in life. Hopefully there's not too many bumps in the road, although there always will be. And I hope that whatever struggles that you may be enduring, that I hope you can find some solace and some peace in your life. Yourself, and I hope to see you again in another video real soon. Goodbye for now, and